Arkadaşlar merhaba, Hardware Plus'a hepiniz hoş geldiniz. Bugün çok ilginç bir röportajla karşı karşıyayız. Kendisine zaten sözü vereceğim biraz sonra, Randall'dan dinleyeceğiz kim olduğunu. Ama büyük bir Hollywood yönetmeni bizimle birlikte diyebilirim. Bu güzel deneyimle birlikte bir VR projesi var, Defrost adında. Bu Defrost adındaki projeyi geldik, denedik burada ve ardından Randall'la ufak bir röportaj yapacağız bununla ilgili. Altyazılardan takip edebilirsiniz diye örnekliyor. Ardından ben röportaja geçiyorum. Hi Randall.
Hi.
First of all, welcome to Turkey, Istanbul. I hope that you are enjoying the city well.
Very much. I'm especially enjoying this lab.
Oh, yeah.
It's great.
We are in VR first, actually, really the first VR lab in the whole world that was created in Istanbul, and that's a beautiful thing. Okay, can you please introduce yourself to our audience?
Well, I'm Randall Kleiser, and I've been directing feature films for about 40 years, and recently switched over to VR to try the new experimental technology.
Yeah, actually we saw at your presentation that I was curious how you got involved in VR, but it turns out you have a pretty big history with interactive motion pictures and some innovative things. So can you explain that a little bit for our audience?
Well, I started off with an attraction at Disneyland called Honey, I Shrunk the Audience, where we were trying to make it look as if it was a live presentation on a stage. And that was my first attempt at what we call immersive entertainment. Mm-hmm. Then I did a project for the U.S. government that allowed soldiers to go through an experience of blowing up in a Humvee. And that was virtual reality, too, is to teach them so that they would not be frightened if it happened to them. And then I got involved with doing a narrative, a show called Defrost, and we've now done 12 episodes of that same story.
Okay, we are here and we just witnessed the first episode, the pilot episode, and after the interview I'm planning on getting the second episode as well.
I think they're watching it now.
Yes, arkadaşlar şu anda arkamızda insanlar ikinci bölümü de tecrübe ediyorlar, ikinci bölümü de deniyorlar. Ben de röportajdan sonra ikinci bölüme bir göz atacağım. So Randall, looks like this is the first VR series that has been created. Is it correct?
I think it's so. I haven't heard of any others, but there may be somebody out there doing one. I don't know.
Okay, what is the synopsis of this beautiful VR show?
It's about a woman who wakes up after being frozen for 30 years and meeting her family for the first time since then. And they've all changed. And it's how she's adjusting to the change.
And we were just meeting with our family in the first episode, and they are all, of course, 30 years older and everything. So, about the stationary position, so the demo, oh, it's not a demonstration, it's a TV show episode. The episode had two different parts that put us in the immersive side of things. First one that our husband wants us to squeeze our hands,
right,
just to show that we are there and we are listening and we are reacting.
Right.
So that was one, and the other one is we are shown our true self, our face through a mirror.
Right.
These two sections have some kind of immersion in them, but there is no interaction right now. So do you plan on anything interactive in the future? Maybe not in the Defrost side of things, but in the future projects?
Well, we did try using smells recently when we did it. At the beginning, it's a medicinal smell, and then when they meet the family, we had some perfume to give us a sort of an immersive feeling. And we have tried experimentally touching people when they get touched in the virtual reality. And for some people, it takes them out of it because they know it's not real. And others, if they get into it, they can. It's an added touch. So it depends on the person.
Hmm. Most of the time, people correlate the virtual reality with video games in the mass media and in the tech world industry. So how do you think the motion picture industry claiming the idea of virtual reality projects? So you think we are still at the understanding stage, or are people trying new things? So what are our position on that?
Well, at the moment, the resolution of all the viewing things for live-action VR are kind of low, the viewing systems. So it's not comfortable to look at it for more than 5 or 10 minutes. So I don't think feature films are going to be made for VR until it's easier to look at it. It's higher resolution and better imagery. Then you can watch it for a long time. Mm-hmm.
So we've seen the technical side of things in the presentation, and it seems like still people are trying to find their way out on the camera systems, camera rigs. So what do you think will happen when the camera rigs are going to be cheaper and affordable? Because right now people can go and buy a smartphone and shoot some beautiful sceneries or some beautiful little amateur pictures.
There's a little camera called the Ricoh, I think it's called, R-I-C-O-H, maybe. And it's a very small camera that's a virtual reality camera that's very cheap. I think it's like $300, mm-hmm. and you can shoot VR with that.
Yeah, yeah, there are a bunch of cameras that you can buy on a couple of $100, actually. But still, there are so many technical things that you have to deal with, especially on the stitching side, because
The Ricoh, the little small cameras, they stitch by themselves, and it's very, very easy to use. But the resolution is not super high. I mean, it's kind of low res, but I would say anybody wants to try a VR now should get one of those and experiment with it.
Okay. So about going back to Defrost, there will be 12 episodes, and where could we download them? They will be on YouTube or anywhere?
We're not sure where they're going to be, but in about 6 months, if you Google Defrost, you'll find it.
Okay, right now we can still find it, and also we can watch the trailer, the mini trailer.
Yeah, the trailer's online right now, but we're in post-production on the 11 episodes. We just only finished two, and that's what's being premiered at Cannes next week, mm-hmm. And we're showing it here, preview here. But we're slowly doing them because it's so much technical stuff for the post-production when you're doing visual effects in 360 stereo.
Yeah, off the record, I have heard of a talk of a little application that can be downloaded. So would you want to comment on that?
Yeah, there's a free download of the Nokia stitching software that I think is very promising to make it real easy to do this. Oh. And we're just starting to work on that.
Oh, okay then. Thanks again for all the answers, and I really think that your project is brilliant, and I really hope to see you on the interactive side of things with some gameplay maybe.
I want to learn about that. Yes, I want to try that.
Okay, thank you again.